Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. What a lovely sunny day. It's a little bit nippy out there, though. So if you're going out, wrap up warm, but it's a lovely sunshine today. Good drying day. Doing some washing. Hope you can hear that all right. I've got this horrible hiss still on my computer. I don't seem to be able to fix it, but never mind. But you're in high definition today. High definition picture. Good. So we've got a new song this week. Some of you will know if you came to the Theatre Royal. And then there's a little film later on as well. And a few songs to warm up to start with. So we're going to kick off with Ukulele Lady, which is a new one to the online. We haven't done it online before. So I was able to just change the portrait to landscape, and so we can it's like I said on Wednesday, it's like meeting an old friend again. So I'm sure you all know this one, and of course you can dive straight in with your kazoos as well if you're playing kazoos, of course. So I'm sure you all remember this. So it goes like this. If you like the ukulele lady, the ukulele lady like you. If you like to linger where it's shady, the ukulele lady linger too. If you kiss the ukulele lady while you promise ever to be true, and she sees another ukulele lady fooling around with you, maybe she'll sigh, maybe she'll cry.
Where the tricky wicky wacky boo. If you like the ukulele lady,
that then. Now, did that sound all right? Was the balance all right for you there? It's really loud in my headphones for some reason. Let's go on, turned it up. So hopefully that sounded all right. Your end. I think I'll just give it a little tweak here so we get a little bit of reverberation. Makes it sound a little bit fuller. That's better. Good. So moving on then. Comes a time. I like the high def. Yeah, the high def's good, isn't it? I got a new webcam. So it's... I'm not sure this shirt is very TV friendly, is it? It doesn't look very good on the monitor here, but I don't know. It doesn't. Makes your eyes go all funny. Should be able to see things a little bit clearer. And of course, it's a nice sunny day as well, so there's quite a lot of sunshine coming through, and we've got lights on as well. But it seems to do quite a good job. Good, so comes the time, the Neil Young song. I'm sure you all know this. Let's get you warmed up, get your fingers going. With a B flat in there as well. Okay, page. Oh, the page. I beg your pardon. Volume 4, page 12. Says it on the screen. I forgot to say it. Sorry about that. All right, so two bars on each of the first chords at the top of the page. So, two, three, four. I'm doing two, but one bar on each, aren't I? Two bars on each.
Comes a time when you're drifting. Comes a time when you settle down. Comes a light, feelings lifting. Lift that baby right up off the ground. No, this all world keeps spinning round. It's a wonder tall trees ain't laying down. Comes a time. There comes a time. There comes a time. And I, we were captured, we took our souls and we flew away. We were right, we were given, that's how we kept what we gave away. Oh, this song.
So that should have warmed your fingers up a bit. Got you going into the groove. So, volume 1, page 21. If paradise is half as nice. And this has got an F minor in it. Little introduction to an F minor. There are more coming up later on. Okay. So not only is it an exercise in playing the F minor, but also an exercise in trying not to lose your place. As it does go on a bit. All right, so it's like this in the key of C. La 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 la. They say paradise is up in the stars, but I needn't sigh because it's so far, 'cause I know it's worth a hell on earth for me where you are. A look from your eyes, a touch of your hand, and I seem to fly to some other land. When you are around, my heart always pounds just like a brass band. Is half as nice as heaven that you take me to. Who needs paradise? I'd rather have you. Oh yes, I'd rather have you. La la la. I'd rather have you. La 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 la. They say paradise is up in the stars, but I needn't sigh because it's so far, 'cause I know it's worth a heaven on earth. From your eyes, a touch of your hand, and I seem to fly to some other land. When you are around, my heart always pounds just like a brass band. If paradise is half as nice as heaven that you take me to, who needs paradise? I'd rather have you. Oh yes, I'd rather you. La 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 la. If paradise is half as nice as heaven that you take me to, who needs paradise? I'd rather have. Yes, I'd rather have you. La 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 la. There we are. Andy Fair with a low song there. Good. So that was the F minor. So these are sort of a few of the oldies, really. And another one, volume 1, page 32, which is Jambalaya, Hank Williams' song. And of course, at the end of the lines there, you've got the G, G seventh to C. So if you're a little, you're not too sure about playing up the dusty end, this is a nice easy introduction and way to do it. If we go to close-up cam, oh yeah, look at that, there's the G. So you just slide that shape up to the fifth fret and then move your little finger, your ring finger, one fret up. Okay, so that gives you a G7, and then take the whole lot up to the seventh fret, back to the G shape, close it up, and that gives you the C. So you've got the G, G7 and C. Dead easy. All you got to do is just slide your hand up and down at the end of that line. And you'll just go, oh, I'm playing up the dusty end. This is good. Okay, so. Of course, I suppose some of you might be doing this, you know, starting to do this now. It's pronounced Tibe Do's and Fontin O's, by the way. I don't know if you knew that, but Andrew Sheba did a whole lecture about this song when we first did it. The Tibe Do's and the Fontin O's were very famous Cajun families, so they were the real thing. So this goes like this. Goodbye, Joe, you gotta go, me oh my oh. You gotta go and pull the pier road down a bayou. My Yvonne, sweetest one, oh me oh my oh. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou. Jambalaya, crawfish pie, and filet gumbo. This tonight I'm gonna see my share of meal. Guitar, filthy job, and big ale. Danny McGann will have big fun on the burn. Tibe Do's, don't you know, the place is buzzing. Kinfolk come to see Yvonne by the dozen. Dress in style, go hog wild, go meal mile. Danny McGann will have big fun. Jambalaya, crawfish pie, and a filet gumbo. Cause tonight I'm gonna see my share of meal. The guitar, filthy jaw, and the gale. Johnny McGann will have the fun all the time. Good. Always thought it was a bit. Hank Williams was a bit lazy, really, on the third verse when he takes half of verse one and half of verse two and puts them together for verse three. I think he should have written a third verse, quite frankly. There's no excuse for it. Anyway, so volume three, page 37, Island of Dreams. It's where we live, isn't it? Oh, maybe not. So, what is striking about this song? Well, you've got this little change on the fourth line. The B seventh, C, G, and the D seventh, and the G. And that little run there goes quite quickly. So you don't want to be resting on your laurels too much. When it comes along, get in there. All right. So the first and the fourth lines are your starter for 10. And it goes like this, 2, 3. Mm-hmm. Yes. Lovely. Good. So, moving on. Volume 4, page 67. World Without Love. And here's the F minor again, in bucket loads. So you had a little taster of it earlier on. This is a really good song for practicing the F minor. Good, so two bars of C. Two, three, four.
Please lock me away. Don't allow the day here inside where I hide.
Lovely song, Lennon and McCartney. I don't think they ever recorded it. Well, the Beatles certainly didn't. Good. Right, so volume 3, page 28, Feels Like Home. So this proved quite popular on the top 20. So we'll. It's an exercise in phrasing, firstly. And the other thing is we've got this G sus. so if we look at the close up tone, what you can see, I think, is a G shape. I don't think this is written in the book, actually. But it's a G shape, and then you're adding your little finger. Just sort of tucked in underneath. So you get that bit at the end. So that's what you're looking to get at. And you lift up, just lift it off before the upstroke. So you're going... and then up. Do 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 do. And that's that little bit there at the end of the line, where it says the G sus. So. We got the first two lines as your introduction. I'll play it with the plectrum today, I think. So it goes like this. Two, three. I hope you were getting that little bit in there. Nice little passing note. Linda Ronstadt is the one you need to look it up. If you look it up, the Randy Newman version is very nice, but Linda Ronstadt does a really great version of that. Well worth a listen. So, a new song. Oh, exciting. A Horse With No Name, which is volume 4, page 4. First song in the book, I think. So, I think this works nicely if it's finger picked and strummed with the fingers rather than a noisy plectrum. And it's sort of slightly deceptive in its simplicity, really. Only three chords, but he's cutter going, oh dear. Let's have a look in the close-up. So you've got a D minor, which is there, and the A seventh suspended fourth is just that finger on there. So it's just your ring finger on the second fret on the C string. So really you've got to do is just lift these two off. You're lifting your index and your middle finger off together and whacking them down at the same time, which is a little bit tricky. Just lifting those two off, so and then whacking them on again. So that's one thing you have to contend with. Then when you get to the next to the chorus, it goes from the A seventh sus four, and you think, oh, it's going to go to somewhere different because it's a chorus, but it doesn't. It goes back to the D minor, so that's one to look out for, and then to the E minor seventh. And what you need to do with that is play, it's usually your second and third fingers, so you just drop them down there. Okay, so you've got the D minor and then you go down and back again. And that's the easiest way to play it, rather than using your fingers around here, turning your hand and things like that. Just use those two fingers. Your middle and your ring finger. Two and three. There. To play that. And as per usual, I will play it through for you. I'm sure you all know it. Everybody seemed to know it on Wednesday, which was a breath of fresh air, because the week before nobody heard the Willin. So I'll play it through. There's a little bit of phrasing it needs watching out for at the ends of the chorus, but I'll run through it first and then we'll have a go. So there's two bars at the top, so two, two. First part of the journey, I was looking at all the life. There were plants and birds and rocks and things. There were sand and hills and rings. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz in the sky with no clouds. The heat was hot and the ground was dry and the air was full of sound. And I've been out of the rain in the desert. You can remember your name, 'cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La 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 la. After 2 days in the desert sun, my skin began to turn red. After 3 days in the desert fun, I was looking at a riverbed. The story it told of a river that flowed made me sad to think it was dead. You see, I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain in the desert. You can remember your name, 'cause there ain't no one for to give you pain. La 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 la. After 9 days I let the horse run free, 'cause the desert had turned to sea. There were plants and birds and rocks and things, and there was sand and hills and is a desert with a life underground and a perfect disguise above. Under the cities lies a heart made of ground, but the humans will give it no love. You see, I've been through the desert on a horse with no name. It felt good to be out of the rain in the desert. You can remember your name, 'cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. La la la. Okay, so I'm sure you knew it. Sorry about the cough. Got a tickle. I'm sure you know the song. So I've been playing it with my fingers rather than the plectrum because I think it sounds a little bit nicer. And you can get that triplet strum going with this that we know so well. And then you can put in the 4-1-4-2 as well, which you also know so well. I'll whack in the close-up cam over here. So the 4-1-4-2. And that works quite nicely when you get to the chorusy bit. And then you get to the la-las and you go... You can just finger pick it at the end, so you can mix it up a little bit to get the general feel of it. Okay. So we'll play it through again. Get a chance to do it. I'm going to give it. I'm going to whack up a load of reverb now because it's one of those songs that needs real sort of echo on it. So I'm turning this up quite a lot now. So don't worry, I'm not going right up here, but it's not the machine that's doing it. It's me that's doing it. Okay. So it goes like this. 2, 3, 4. On the first part of the journey, I was looking at all the life. The plants and birds and rocks and things. There was sand and hills and rings. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz in the sky. With no cloud, the heat was hot and the ground was dry, but the air was full of sound. Been through the desert on a horse with no name, it felt good to be out of the rain. In the desert, you can remember your name, cause there ain't no one for to give you no pain. Today we're going to look at the Z chord. So how do you play the Z chord? Just rest your fingers gently across the strings and strum. Don't press too hard or it'll ring out and sound horrible. Don't press too softly. That'll ring out and sound horrible. Just press enough. Any you get this nice percussive effect. So when would you use it? Well, some people use it when they forget a chord. Gets them out of trouble. And sometimes we just use it as percussion. I tend to use it on a few songs. So back in the old days when we all used to meet up together, I used to throw this in as a whole verse. There were a couple of songs that I used to always do it in. And here are some examples coming up now.
Won't be worried long. I ask the judge now, what's gonna be my fine? Oh Lord, I ask the judge now, what's gonna be my fine? Ask the judge now, what's gonna be my fine? 21 years on the Rocky Mountain line. Is it a judge worried man? They put me into jail with a judge all a-writing for robbing Captain Farrell on Kilgara Mountain. But they didn't take my fists, and I knocked the jailer down and bid me farewell to this tight-fisted town. With a mush and a little quack for the daddy-o, quack for the daddy-o, as we stand, I'm getting ready to go. And listen here, pal, for your road is run and your tightrope breaks in two. It's a mighty big world you're standing on, and it keeps going round without a little old you know. Ooh, boodle-lam, 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 boo. And toodle-lam, 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 too.
Since we've been doing this online, I've been told to stop doing that, because it just throws people a curveball and people get confused. Well, what chord's he playing now? So I've stopped doing it, really. So by all means, use it occasionally, but don't overdo it. And that is the Z chord. Good, okay, so that was the Z chord, just very briefly, really. But yeah, so do it. We can do that in the theatre, and I promise I won't use it for the B flat. You can use it whenever you like, really. But I was told that actually it puts people off if I do it when we're doing it online, when it's just me. It's all right if there's a whole group of people, because then you can hear what the other stuff's going on. But when I do it on my own, it puts people off. But I'm going to do it on the next song anyway, so which is Sweet Home. So, and then it'll give you an idea and you can play along to that if you have a crack at it. Just a very quick note, Vanessa, I can see you struggled to send the video in and I hope you got it. No, I didn't get it, but I did send you an email to use WeTransfer. So if you're going to send in a video, try using WeTransfer, all one word, WeTransfer.com. It's dead easy to use. You just upload the file and then send it to the email address and off it goes. It's piece of cake, really. So that's the best way to do it. But I didn't get your video. No, I'm afraid of what I saw your emails. Okay, so yeah, normally we do this at the end of the show, but we'll do show at the end of the class, but we'll do it now, because and then it'll just illustrate the Z chord. So Sweet Home, which is volume 2, page 51. Okay. Takes a little practice, the Z chord. If you're not used to it, it takes a little practice. Just get your hand so that it's lightly on the top of the strings and it doesn't ring out. And you sort of, after a while, you get used to how much pressure to put on it. Okay, but I will do the Z chord on this. So, on the E minor bit, just to show you how it works. Well, it goes like this. 2, 3, 4. Two hobos on a railroad line, I'm getting ready to go. Pulling on a bottle of burgundy wine, and I'm getting ready to go. Well, they couldn't hear the southbound whistle when the Dixie Flyer burned around the bend. Punched their ticket for the promised land, and I'm getting ready to go.
like a heavenly choir, and I'm getting ready to go. Old Farmer John must be sleeping sound. They've shucked that corn and passed it around. The old man's wife got a shotgun down, and I'm getting ready to go. Sweet home, loving heaven, heaven. Sweet home, can't you hear me singing low? Sweet home, oh Lordy, I'll be traveling. Throw those gates wide open, 'cause I'm getting ready to go. And listen here, pal, for your road is run and your tightrope breaks in two. It's a mighty big world you're standing on, and it keeps going round with that little old you-know-who. Boodle-am, 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 boo. And toodle-am, 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 too. And shake a leg, shake a leg, shake a leg, shake a leg now. And break a leg, drag a leg, shake a leg, and grab a leg. So long, good luck, and great to know ya. I'm getting ready to go. May the Lord above take a liking to ya, and I'm getting ready to go. It's a short life of trouble, so don't make more. And death comes creeping round your back door. But don't knock twice, brother, that's for sure. And I'm getting ready to go. Sweet home, loving heaven, heaven. Sweet home, can't you hear me singing low? Throw those gates wide open, 'cause I'm getting ready to go.
So there, that was the Zed chord in situ in a song. It probably sounds a bit weird when me doing it on my own, but play along to that anyway. Good. So, last week, the week before that, we had a new song, which was Willin, volume 4, page 65. So there's not much to say about this really. It's all fairly straightforward, I think, and you've got those downstrokes in the last bit of the chorus. I've been asked to explain the word or to pronounce the words. It's Tucson, obviously, Tucumcari, Techepi, and Tonopah. So those are the words of the places. I've heard of Tucson, but never any of the others. All right, so the first couple of lines are your introduction. It goes like this, 2, 3, 4. I've been warped by the rain, driven by the snow, drunk and dirty, and don't you know, but I'm still willing. I was out on the road late at night. See my pretty Alice in every headlight. Alice, Dallas, Alice. I've been from Tucson to Tucumcari,
stove in, but I'm still on my feet, but I'm still willing. Smuggle some smokes and folks from Mexico, baked by the sun every time I go to Mexico. I've been from Tucson to Tucumcari, Tehachapi to Tonopah. Give me weed, white sand, wine, and you show me a sign, I'll be willing to be moving. I'll be willing to be moving. I'll be willing.
Good, we've done some quite hippie-ish songs, haven't we? Here comes another one. Gentle on My Mind, Volume 3, page 30. White, are they clothes? No, they're not. Whites are pills. So, it's another song about drugs. Weed, whites and wine. Weed is obviously, well, you know what weed is. And yeah, whites is the pills. So, uppers and downers, I suppose. Well, uppers probably. Anyway. All right, so Gentle on My Mind. Remember, close up game. Play the E minor there, and then you just drop your middle finger down to play the C. So rather than playing it with your third finger, maybe the second finger. It is so much easier. Okay. So, four notes on the top. Two, three, four. Knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk, that makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up and stashed behind your couch. And it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that have dried upon some lines that keeps you in the back roads by the rivers of my memory, keeps you ever gentle on my mind. It's not clinging to the rocks and ivy planted on their columns now to bind me, or something that somebody said because they thought we fit together walking. Just knowing that the world will not be cursing or forgiving when I walk along some railroad track and find that you're moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, and for eyes you're just gentle on my mind. Though the wheat fields and clotheslines and junkyards and highways come between us, and some other woman's crying to her mother 'cause she turned and I was gone, I still might run in silent tears of joy, might stain my face, and the summer sun might burn me till I'm blind.
not to where I cannot see you, walking on the back roads by the rivers flowing gentle on my mind. I dip my cup of soup back from the gurgling, crackling cauldron in some tree yard. My beard a roughening coal pile and a dirty hat pulled low across my face. Through cupped hands round a tin can, I pretend to hold you to my breast and pine. Let your waving from the back roads by the rivers of my memory, ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind.
That's one of my favorites. It's great, isn't it? Okay, Dougie. I've moved some of these around a bit, haven't I? Good, okay. Only you and you alone, which I don't think we did at the on Wednesday as we ran out of time. I can't remember now. So this is volume 3, page 50. And of course this has the C minor in it, which you can use your third finger. I know in the book it says your fourth finger, but actually in on the screen I think it says third finger, which makes life a lot easier because there's the C like that. And to play the C minor, you just put your finger across all three frets, or three strings, to get that. It makes it that much easier. Lots of B7s to E minors as well. Nice. Yeah, but play that with your third finger and you'll find it a little bit easier. So verse 2 is your starter. Do do do.
My one and only you. You're
terrible temptation to sort of put in sort of a really, really cheesy American speaking in that bit, but nah, we didn't. Right, we're going to go over time today, I know that, so if you've got to go off, you can watch it on the catch-up. I get a kick out of you, let's do that. Volume 3, page 36. So, this is all nicely phrased, good phrasing here, and you've got the knocking bit down the bottom. And some nice chord changes as well. Don't have to worry about inversions, unless you wanted to invert the A minor at the end there, which is quite nice. You can move that up to here, the fourth fret. Although, actually, while we're talking about that, here, look. That's an A minor, obviously, which we know and love so well. But if you slide that up to the fifth fret, believe it or not, that's an A minor as well. You can do a G seventh shape there on the top three strings. It's an A minor, but you can also just put one finger on. So in this particular song, you can go from C to A minor. It sounds slightly different to that. But that's a legitimate inverted A minor. All right, so it goes like this: two, three, four. Cocaine. Good. Norman gritting his teeth now. I know he likes the other one. Other version. Right. So, moving swiftly on. True faith, then. Let's do that. So, this is volume 3, page 61. We've got a couple of bars on each of the chords at the top. This is just a question of holding the pace, I think. All right, so it goes 2, 3, 4. A favourite of a lot of yous, so that was good. Right, well, we'll finish up then with Whiskey in the Jar. You've got value for money this week, haven't you? Cool, blimey, I'm way over time. But if you've had to go, actually, if you've had to go, then you've had to go, so you won't be able to hear this. But Well, if you've had to go, then you could catch up on the catch up. Doesn't make sense, does it? Never mind. So, I tend to do the Z chord on the fifth verse, which I will do today, just in case you get confused when we play this live, but otherwise I won't normally do it. But just to sort of, so you can have a crack at it as well. And that, the A minor is quite a good, and the F, if you wanted to do that as a little, well, certainly the A minor here works nicely as a inverted chord as well. All right, so it goes it goes like this. 2, 3. As I was going over the Cork and Kerry Mountain, I met with Captain Farrell and his money he was counting. First I drew my pistol, and then I drew my rapier.
Daddy, oh, there's whiskey in the jar. And I'm a sugar.
There you are, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that. Now you can get out into the sunshine, do a spot of gardening. We'll hang the rest of the washing up. Thanks for tuning in and everything. We're here again next week. We're also down at the Theatre Royal as well. I think there's still some tickets left if you wanted to do that. How long that will last, I don't know. But I think this can... we'll just keep this ticking over the Friday mornings anyway. Until something drastic happens. Okay, thanks a lot for tuning in. And I'll leave you with... sing along with old Warren. Okay? Take care, everybody. Stay safe.